Talk to me about this fight here, Freddie. I mean, how excited are you for this Terrence Crawford and Victor Postol?
Yeah, this is a big fight. I mean, this is one that I think it's a 50-50 fight. I think it's the best fight in the best. We got our work cut out for us. We got a lot of sparring partners in mind right now because he does switch righty to lefty and so forth, and everyone's making a pretty big deal about that, but it's not like they invented the wheel. It's been done many times before. You know, we saw Marvin Hagler fail with it with Sugar Ray Leonard. We saw, you know, Mickey Ward do it quite well with a lot of success with knockouts. So, you know, again, it's something we have to deal with, and Frankie Gomez is going to be one of our sparring partners because he does switch quite a bit.
That's good work.
He's a little bit shorter though, but he's a very, very sound fighter, as you know. And we get Taras coming in also, who's can go both ways, and the Olympian from Russia, and so we've got a lot of guys in mind, and we'll be 100% ready for this fight. I know we got our work cut out for us, but that's what this is all about.
Are you surprised you said he's going to destroy him and knock him out there? We don't hear Terrence talk that way, and we heard him today.
Yeah, you know, he's a little cocky, but I like fighters that assure themselves. I mean, I have no problem with that. The other thing is, wish him best of luck and go with my fighter and get ready. That's all I want to do. So, we got our work cut out for us. We're in a tough fight, yes, but this is what boxing is all about.
Freddie, I got to ask you, some people are somewhat surprised that this fight is happening now. Both fighters are still, they're basically at the point of their height. The winner obviously goes on to bigger things, but are you surprised that this fight has been made this easy and that it was this easy?
I am surprised because, they waited too long for Pacquiao, Mayweather, I think, and fights like that and so forth, and this is the best fight and the best. And as you said, the winner will go on to bigger and better things, and the loser will have to go back to Nebraska.
Pick it up.
Khan actually did what Mcgregor did. You know, he moved up in weight. He faced a bigger guy. The outcome didn't benefit him. But can you compare that at all? McGregor's move to fight Nate Diaz and Khan's move to fight Canelo?
Yeah, well, you know, they both jumped up too far. I mean, it was just like they weren't ready for that. I mean, you know, once Amir got hit, it was over. I mean, he fought beautiful five rounds, but he couldn't stay disciplined. And when he fainted, and then Khan reached, he walked right into the shot. I mean, it was a great knockout. I mean, but the thing is, Conor moving up in two weight classes and fighting a very tough guy, very good street fighter. Mm-hmm. They are really tough guys. I mean, him and his brother both. And, they talk about a rematch and stuff like that, but, I don't know if a rematch is really sellable, to be honest with you, you know? I think the matchmakers have to be, better and more... put the better styles together. It's like, you know, I don't think it's that hard to put the kid from Cuba, Regan Dow, right?
Yeah.
No one wants to use him anymore, right? Yeah. Because he kind of doesn't, he's not the most exciting fighter in the world. But if you put him in there against a Russian gold medalist, Melanchenko, right? That turns into a great fight because you got a pressure guy and a counterpuncher. I mean, with those type of guys, you need to put the right people in and so forth.
Yeah.
And then, you know, they got Ronda Rousey beat. That was a mistake. And now he got the Irish kid beat, and that was a mistake. Now he loses two of his biggest pay-per-view fighters. You know, so, and then now they have to get wins back to get back to that level. So... matchmaking needs to be a little bit cleaned up, I think. I don't know. Maybe I'll become a matchmaker.